Several groups are now at the Philippine Supreme Court to file more petitions against the controversial anti-terrorism law. Mike Navalia joins us on the line for the details. Go ahead, Mike.
Hi, Michelle. More petitions are expected to be filed today against the Anti-Terrorism Act. We're expecting a total of 15 petitions in all. That means that there will be about 4 new petitions today. Earlier, the group led by Bagong Alyansa Makabayan, who filed a 10th petition against the new law by email on Sunday, submitted a physical copy of their petition. Bayan Secretary General Renato Reyes Jr. noted the growing number of petitions against the anti-terrorism measure, attributing it to the vague provisions of the law. He vowed the new law will not stop them from holding protest actions during President Duterte's State of the Nation address on Monday. The group of former Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio and former Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales also filed a physical copy of the 11th petition against the Anti-Terrorism Act. They filed it by email yesterday. Now, also filing a physical copy as of the moment is a group of veteran journalists, lawmakers, human rights defenders, and constitution framers. This will now constitute the 12th petition against the new law. Petitioners Shel Jokno, former Representative Erin Tanyada, and Representative Kit Belmonte are at the Supreme Court to physically file the petition. They filed their petition by email yesterday. This group includes journalists and columnists led by Maria Ceres Doyo, Joan Maglipon, Maria Ressa, and John Nery, Senators Laila De Lima and Francis Pangilinan, Constitution framers Florangel Rosario Braid and Edmundo Garcia, and other former lawmakers. Now, we're expecting 3 more petitions later to be filed by the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, a group of Muslims, and a youth group. They should be able to file it any moment now, Mimi, although expecting another group in the afternoon.
Okay. Thank you very much for that update, Attorney Mike Navalio.